Hello everyone and welcome back to another session of Daily Current Affairs by SSB Crack Exams. I am Chaitanya Purab and I'll be taking you today's session. So let's start talking about SSB Crack Exams. So this is a one-stop solution for all the major differentiated examinations like FCAT, NDA, CDS. For more details regarding the courses that we offer for these exams, you can visit our website learn.ssbcrackexams.com. For more details, you can also follow us on Instagram and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. SSB Crack Exams, where you can find regular current affair video updates and other differentiated video updates. You can also follow us on Instagram, like I said, and don't forget to download our Android app from Google Play Store, SSB Crack Exams. Now let's move ahead. So we shall start our session with the question of the day from yesterday's session. So I asked you guys about basic and factual details about CII. So we discussed CII in yesterday's one of the news, Confederation of Indian Industry, and this works to create and sustain an environment conducive to the development of India, partnering industry, government and civil society through advisory and consultative processes, right? It is a non-government, non-profit, industry-led and industry-managed organization, and it was established back in 1895 and it has just celebrated 125 years of its existence. Okay, now let's move ahead guys and talking about the first article. So index of 8 core industries for the year of 2019-20 has been released by the Office of Economic Advisor, and it has been released up to the point of April 2020. Now since it has been released by Office of Economic Advisor, Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, they have also collectively released the index of 8 core industries for the month of April, like I said, and this is the graph that has shown. And of course you can clearly see the difference in the growth and basically the decline in the growth after especially February 2020, of course owing to the COVID-19 overall you can say market crisis in India also and all over the world also. So that is why an effect on these industries can be seen. Further, the growth rate of index of 8 core industry for April 2020 overall has been declined by 38.1%, which is still provisional and it will change over a period of time. But still, it is as compared to previous year, that is previous month, sorry, for the month of March 2020, it has declined by 38.1%, but in March it was just 9%. In the view of nationwide lockdown during April 2020, due to COVID-19 pandemic, various industries, for example, coal industries, cement, steel industries, natural gas industries, refineries, and crude oil, etc., these industries have suffered a lot owing to two major, you can say, problems. The first one is the international market crisis. The second one being the fact that they are having trouble in, you can say, logistical problems, transportation problems owing to the lockdown. And also one of the problems being that the demand has also been decreased in these sectors, of course, due to the lockdown. Further, the summary of the index of 8 core industries up to April 2020, I'm going to show you that too the figures are in percentage. So I'll show you the figures for each and every industries, the 8 industries. So coal production has been declined by 15.5%, crude oil has been declined by 6.4%, natural gas has suffered the maximum blow because of the lockdown and it has declined by 19.9%, pardon me. Further, petroleum refineries has also declined 24.2%. Then fertilizers has been declined by just 4.1% because in the rural sectors, the lockdown has not affected that much owing to good policies and schemes by the central government. Apart from that, the steel industry has suffered heavily because it heavily relies on transportation, and also the demand has been very low because of the construction sector, the lockdown of construction sector, the construction sector, and you can say that particular region, there has been a steep decline in the demand of steel and other you can say raw materials which is related to construction work, for example steel, cement and all. So that is why you'll also see 86% of decline in cement production. Also apart from that, electricity generation also declined by 22.8% owing to the fact that many small level industries or non-essential industries were also shut down because of the coronavirus lockdown, right? Now let's move ahead. The next article is about Mission Sagar, and INS Kesari, which was deployed for this particular mission, arrived at the Madagascar at one of the ports of Madagascar, and basically it arrived on 27th of May only. But an official ceremony for handing over the medicines and all the required articles that were to be given to the Madagascar government by Indian government was organized on 29th of May 2020. Further, the Indian side was represented by Ambassador of India to Madagascar, who is currently Mr. Abhay Kumar. Also, the deployment also resonates the vision of our Prime Minister of security and growth for all in the region, that is full form for Sagar basically, and highlights the importance of accorded by India to relations with countries of IOR, that is Indian Ocean Region. Now, what are the countries that come in this? So in Indian Ocean Region we have Maldives, countries like Maldives, then Sri Lanka, then of course Madagascar. So all these small countries, island countries basically, and these come under Indian Ocean Region. Further, let's move on to our next news. So next news is about Army Commanders Conference, which is held. The first phase was held for 27th to 29th of May in 2020. See, what is this Army Commanders Conference? So this is an APEX level biannual event. That means that it happens every 2 years, which facilitates conceptual level deliberations culminating in important policy decisions which is related to defense sector. See, it is organized usually in two phases. The first phase of the conference was conducted at the South Block of PMO, Raisina Hills, New Delhi, from 27 to 29th of May 2020. It was actually scheduled to be held in April 2020, but due to, of course, the lockdown, it was postponed, and later on, the first phase was held between 27 to 29th of May. The second phase, however, it will be held in the month of June. Expected to be held in the month of June, where CDS, that is Chief of Defence Staff, and the Defence Minister will also, these two are also expected to address the conference. Further, over these 3 days, the Indian Army's APEX leadership deliberated upon various aspects related to existing and developing security challenges. Right, so like I said, the topics of discussions are mostly related to defense sector and security sector. In addition, human resource management issues, studies pertaining to ammunition and management, merger of co-located training establishments, and merger of military training directorate with headquarters Army Training Command were also discussed. So these were the important topics which over which the discussions were held. Also, the Board of Governor meetings of the Army Welfare Housing Organization and the Army Welfare Education Society were also organized during this particular event. Okay, so that's it from this particular news. Moving on, the next news is coming from INS Kalinga. So, a 2 MW solar power plant inaugurated at INS Kalinga. Now, this initiative comes under the Government of India to promote solar power, and one of the objectives of Indian government to achieve 100 gigawatt of solar power by 2022 only, and which is a part of course, National Solar Mission. Further, a 2 MW solar photovoltaic plant was commissioned at INS Kalinga, and it is the largest in the ENC, that is Eastern Naval Command, and has an estimated life of 25 years from the date of launching. Also, INS Kalinga has taken significant strides in green initiatives. Apart from that, apart from installing the power plant, solar power plant, including afforestation, then numerous plantation drives, coastal cleanup drives, and also protection of geo heritage site. For example, one of those is Yera Matti Tibalu, which is a red sand stones, right? Further moving ahead, another news is from INS Kalinga also. So they have also laid a foundation stone for a missile park named Agni Prastha, which will be set up at again INS Kalinga. So the foundation stone was put up on 29th of May for this missile park, and the name was given as Agni Prastha. And this aims to basically capture glimpses of missile history of INS Kalinga since 1981, that is since it was founded, INS Kalinga. And also, this will, once it is completely constructed, it will be dedicated to the officers and the sailors and the other support staff of INS Kalinga. Also, the missile park has been set up with a replica of missiles and the ground support equipment that showcase the evolution of missiles handled specifically and particularly by INS Kalinga. The main attraction would be, of course, P-70 Amethyst, an underwater launched anti-ship missile from the arsenal of the old INS Chakra submarine, which was in service for Indian Navy during 1988 to 1991. Now, further, the next news is about the COVID-19 update in India. So, as of 30th of May, 8 a.m. in the morning, the total number of positive cases or active cases, to be particular, is 86,422, with the number of cured cases has also breached 80,000 mark, and it has reached to 82,369, which is a very good news. Unfortunately, the number of death has also increased and it has reached 4,971. Now it's quiz time, guys. The first question for today is, where is the missile park Agni Prastha situated? So it has recently been, the foundation stone has been laid by INS Kalinga recently. So the correct answer for this would be INS Kalinga, option A. The next question is, where is the heritage site of Yeramatti Dibalu located? So it is actually located in the district of Vizag, that is Vishakhapatnam in Andhra Pradesh. The correct answer is option B. The last question for today is, Army's Commanders Conference is held after every, and your options are 4 years, 5 years, 1 year or 2 years. So it is a biannual event. That means it is held after every 2 years. Okay, and the first phase has been held for this particular year to 2020, and it was held between 27th of May to 29th of May, like we discussed in today's article. And the second phase is expected to be held in the month of June. Okay guys, so that's it from today's session, and we shall end our session with the question of the day. The question of the day is, basically you have to answer about Army Welfare Housing Organization and Army Welfare Education Society. Write your answers in the comment section. The correct answer to this question will be told in the next session, in tomorrow's session. Till then, thank you, have a nice day, and Jai Hind.